guys, it's Monday morning. Actually, it's Monday afternoon. I kind of slipped in because I feel like I kind of earned it. Anyway, I'm out here at a pawn shop again. Thought I'd do a little bit of that before I went back home. Found this pawn shop. No good deals on the inside of it. But I thought you would enjoy this sign they have in the window. Okay. Attention, idiots. There's only three reasons to unholster your loaded firearm. One, robbing us. Number two, you are shooting the person that is robbing us. And number three, you are a complete idiot. It keeps going. Please do not unholster a loaded weapon in our store. If you do, the following will apply to each of the above. Number one, you will be shot. Number two, you will be thanked. And number three, you will be treated like an idiot and asked to leave. That's pretty good. That's pretty good right there. Apparently they must have had a few incidents where people were like, pulling out loaded weapons and saying, hey, how much would you give me for this? Yeah, just because somebody deals in firearms doesn't mean that they like having a loaded firearm unholstered in front of them. Quite the opposite, actually. Keep this in mind, guys. This is the fifth store I've been to, shoe shopping. And as you can see, I am in need of some new shoes. This is the kind of shoe that I like. Okay, it's got that nice brown leather look with the copper rivets there. Very outdoorsy, kind of steampunk look. That's what I like. Alright, it should be simple to find a replacement for this. But after five stores, in that style, with a nice thin leather, brown leather look, this is all I'm finding. This is all I'm finding. White soles. Okay, it doesn't take a whole lot of sense to realize shoes walk on the ground. The ground is made up mostly of dirt, dust, mud. I can walk 10 feet in these and they're going to look dirty and dingy. This is common sense. Whoever came up with the idea of making shoe soles out of white rubber, you're stupid. That's just dumb. Why did you do that? Why would anybody do this? And why can't I find an alternative? Why can't I find a variation of this with the brown soles? Why don't they exist anymore? Okay. I'll get it figured out. Well, guys, it's Tuesday morning. The fair has been over for a day. I'm still out here at the RV park. Mostly because it was a better deal to pay for it by the week, so I'm paid up for the next few days. Just wanted to take it easy. But it's Tuesday now, and it's about time for me to go ahead and start heading towards the next one. It's about 3 o'clock now. You can blame the rain and, well, Valve software for making their game so addictive for the late start. I've got my camper all hooked up. Haven't got the power unhooked yet, but I thought I would go ahead and take this little opportunity to say goodbye to this nice little park that has been my home for the past 10, 11 days. So, goodbye, you soothing little creek that I could see outside my door every time I open the door in the morning. Goodbye to you, shower house that looks like a log cabin made out of cross ties. Goodbye to you, utility sink outside the shower house, where the hot and the cold water are switched around. And there's this sign telling us to help them conserve water. Even though the whole time I was here, the urinal has been running constantly. So goodbye, RV park. Goodbye, RV park in general. Until possibly this same exact week next year. The life of us traveling caricaturists. Gotta keep moving. Well, I'm about halfway back to Tennessee now. I just stopped for a minute to have one of these incredibly healthy truck stop lunches. But I thought I'd go ahead and turn the camera on for a second to show you guys this. This is so pretty. I really hope it comes through on the video. Here's the truck stop that I'm at right now. But look over here to the side over here. The air is kind of still and warm right now. As they say, the still quiet before the storm. But over here on this horizon, you can see the clouds from the storm shadowing up this band in the background. And then in the foreground, a little bit brighter with all those orange dots. Those are pumpkins. It's a pumpkin patch. And then if we spin around here, you got the mountain on this side, jutting up into the sky like that. And all of this with the storm clouds and the sun setting right behind them. Yeah, these are the moments.